everyone. Welcome back to virtual programming with Boys and Girls Clubs of the Vox Valley. My name is Miss Chelsea and I work at the Downtown Club here in Appleton. So for today's art project, I am going to show you how to make hopping origami frogs. So these are really cute paper frogs that actually hop when you press them with your fingers. They're really easy to make and they're a lot of fun to play with. Let's get started with our materials and then I'll show you how to make the frog. So for today's project, the materials you'll be needing will be some thin paper. So I recommend probably not using construction paper this time because when we do origami, that gets too thick and it's very hard to make some of the folds. So I have some blank paper that I'm just going to color. That being said, I also have some coloring supplies, so crayons and markers to color my frog. You will also need a pair of scissors if your paper is not cut to square. If your paper is square, that's great. You can get started right away on the project. And then I have a little bit of glue because I'm going to be adding some eyes and decorations to my frog. So that's kind of an optional one. Basically, you just need your paper cut down to square. Everything else is optional, but I think it's kind of fun to decorate them. And they turn out pretty cute then. So why don't we get started and I'll show you how to make your frog. All right, so as I showed you, I had a piece of blank paper that I cut down to size. I did a 5 inch by 5 inch square. The size of the square doesn't really matter for this project. It just determines the size of your frog. So a smaller square will be a smaller frog and a larger square will be a larger frog. I did color mine green already for the basis of my frog just to save myself a little time in the future. So why don't we get started folding our frog? So if you have only one side that's colored on your sheet, you're going to want to flip it color side down. And our first step is to fold our paper in half. So if you watched our fortune teller video, this is kind of the basic step to making a fortune teller, right? So we fold it in half, then we're gonna fold it in half again the other way. All right. Our next step is to take each corner and fold it into the middle point. Again, this is one of the first steps of our fortune teller. So if you've seen that video, you'll already be a pro. Please make sure that you are folding carefully and that none of your edges are overlapping because otherwise it will be very difficult to finish your frog. Alright, once you have all four corners folded in, you're going to take the corner on your right and fold it in so that this long edge right here matches up with the middle line of the paper. Alright, so fold that down really well. Then you're going to do the same with the other side. So folding it so that this long edge meets up in the middle of the paper. Alright, we've made a little bit of a kite shape right here. See? Our next step is to take the bottom of the paper, so kind of this fatter squatter triangle, and fold it upward like that. Alright. Afterwards, we're going to take the corner of the triangle here, and we're going to fold those edges so that the corner lines up with that middle line of your triangle. So this is a little bit of paper to fold, so just be patient, use your fingernail to press it down. Then you're going to do the same with the other side. You're going to fold that point in. Next, you're going to take the bottom here and fold it up. And then back down again. All right, so we made a little accordion shape here. If you look at it from the side, we folded it up and then folded it back once more. Like I said, making a little accordion shape, making sure we kind of squeeze it together. Our last step is to take the tip of our triangle and fold it down probably about half an inch. All right. And then when we flip our frog over, he's gonna sit just like this, press a finger on him, and away he hops right off the table. So if you'd like, you may add some decorations to your frog. I'm going to be adding probably some spots and some eyes and a little top, and then he'll be all done. I hope you enjoyed making our origami hopping frog. As I said, these are great little toys that you can either run races with your family or your friends, or even use them as little toys with your pets. I know my cat likes to chase anything that moves, so a hopping frog will be pretty fun for him. Anyway, I hope you enjoyed the project. I definitely enjoyed doing it with you. As always, if you followed along and made your own frog, please feel free to share that with us. You can post a picture or comment on the video. I'm always very, very proud of you guys for continuing to learn and grow, even while we have to be at home and can't go to school or to club. I hope these videos are enjoyable and are teaching you new things every single day. I wish each and every one of you the best, and I'll see you on the next video.